Hello, welcome to the second part of the poem, A Prayer for My Daughter. If you have not seen the first video, then please subscribe the channel and touch on the screen. You find this and touch on the playlists and select this playlist. Here you find all the videos. You can also have the video in which it is explained in Kannada. Helen, being chosen, found life flat and dull. We find this Helen in Greek mythology. She had been an extraordinarily beautiful woman. That's why he says chosen. Being chosen means chosen by the God. God made her so very beautiful. She married Menelaus, but she was not happy with that marriage. Then she eloped with the Prince Paris to Troy, and later there was a war because of this woman. Thousands of people were killed in that Trojan War. It was all because of this extraordinarily beautiful woman, that is Helen. And later had much trouble from a fool. The fool is her husband Menelaus. While that great queen that rose out of the spray, this refers to the goddess of love, that is Aphrodite. The legends say that she was born out of the sea. Being fatherless, she could have her way. So she had a freedom to choose any worthy person. But she chose an unworthy person, that is one like the smith, Hephaestus. It's certain that fine women eat crazy salad with their meat. Here, the poet wants to say that these beautiful women eat something that makes them unwise. And they make fool of themselves. They make unwise decisions. Whereby, the horn of plenty is undone. This horn of plenty is like Akshaya Patra. So that means these women have been given with some gift, but that they do not use it properly, they make fool of themselves. And they bring doom to themselves as well as to the others. This is an indirect reference to his beloved Maud Gonne, a very beautiful woman whom he loved a lot, but he was rejected. She rejected him. And he was so very disappointed in life. So the conclusion is that his daughter should not become another Maud Gonne. In courtesy, I would have her chiefly learn it. The poet wants his daughter Annie to learn courtesy, not only just learn, but she should become the mistress of it. Hearts are not had as a gift, but hearts are earned by those that are not entirely beautiful. It means that you cannot have nice people as gifts. One has to earn them by winning them with the courtesy. So normally the women, those who are not so beautiful, win the people's heart. Yet many that have played the fool for beauty's very self has charm made wise. This means the women who made themselves fools by their beauty became later wise after facing difficulties in life. And many a poor man that has roared loud and thought himself beloved. It means many innocent men loved women, those beautiful women, and they thought that those women also loved them, but that was false. These arrogant women do not love anyone. From glad kindness cannot take his eyes. It means if you love a woman who is not so beautiful but very beautiful from inside, so that time you will never go away from her and your life will be beautiful. You will be very happy. May she become a flourishing hidden tree. The poet wants his daughter to grow like a big tree that provides fruits and shelter to many birds and animals. But at the same time, it should not be exposed to the outside world, that all her thoughts may like the linnet be. A linnet is a bright-colored, very active bird. This is a linnet. The poet wants his daughter to have bright ideas, bright thoughts, and have no business but dispensing around their magnanimities of sound. It means that these active birds have no other business other than giving melodious sounds and making the surrounding very cheerful. Nor but in merriment begin a chase, nor but in merriment a quarrel. It means even if these birds chase some other birds or quarrel with other birds, they make these things in a happy mood. So the poet wants that his daughter Annie should live like a linnet, always active but with a bright ideas. Oh, may she live like some green laurel rooted in one dear perpetual place. Laurel tree represents wisdom. Rooted in one dear perpetual place means always rooted to the traditions, to the customs. So the poet wants his daughter to be a traditional woman, grow with the traditional values, and strongly stuck to her place of birth and her people. My mind has dried up of late, because the minds that I have loved, the sort of beauty that I have approved, prosper but little. The poet confesses that the woman whom he loved did not prosper well, and now he has realized that mistake, yet knows that to be choked with hate, that means if we have hatredness in our mind, may well be of all evil's chances chief. There is every chance of acquiring evil things. That means all evil things enter in us when we have hatredness in us. If there is no hatred in mind, assault and a battery of wind can never tear the linnet from the leaf. Even if a strong wind blows, it cannot separate the linnet from the leaf, that means from the tree. It cannot make the bird go away from the tree. It simply means that a mind without hatred is always very strong. An intellectual hatred is the worst, so let her think opinions are accursed. It is to say that the intellectual people are arrogant. They always think that their opinions only are better or the best. So they always force upon their ideas on others. So this is a curse for them and a curse for others. Have I not seen the loveliest woman born out of the mouth of plenty's horn? Now again this refers to the beautiful woman Mardgon. So he says that she was a gifted woman. Because of her opinionated mind, that means because of her arrogance, barter that horn and every good. This means due to her foolishness, she exchanged these good things like a plenty's horn and other good things for an old bellows full of angry wind. The worst and the useless. Considering that all hatred driven hence, that means when a hatred goes out of us, the soul recovers the radical innocence. We become totally innocent and learns at last that it is self-delighting, self-appeasing, self-affrighting. So when you have innocence in you, then you can come to know that it is self-delighting. It gives you delight. And its own sweet will is heaven's will. It means when you have innocence in you, it is heavenly. It is divine. She can be happy still. Though every face should scowl, that means let anybody scowl her or hate her, and every wind quarter howl, let anybody scream at her with hatred, or let anybody burst with anger on her, but still she would be happy, because she has something which is very important, very valuable, that is innocence. So the poet wishes that his daughter should have innocence. She should cultivate innocence and not arrogance. And may her bridegroom bring her to a house where all is accustomed, ceremonious. Now the poet is already thinking of her marriage, Annie's marriage. He wishes that the house where she goes to her husband's house, it should not be a strange one. She should not feel anything strange there. Everything normal as it was there in her house. For arrogance and hatred are the wares peddled in the thoroughfares. This means arrogance and hatred are the things that are sold everywhere on the roads. In other words, we can say that hatred and arrogance are found everywhere. How but in custom and in ceremony are innocence and beauty born? This means innocence and beauty are found in the customs and traditions. Ceremony is a name for the rich hall and custom for the spreading laurel tree. Rich horn means our fortune, good fortune, and that is another name for ceremony. So wherever there is a ceremony, you get good things, and custom and traditions are like our laurel tree. ಈ ಪದ್ಯವನ್ನು ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡಿರತಕ್ಕಂಥ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಇದೆ, ಇದನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ನೀವು ವೀಕ್ಷಿಸಬಹುದು.